Hi guys, it's Xenia. Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm gonna be doing a huge perfumed clutter. So I basically went into my collection and I got rid of 27 perfumes, and I'm really happy about that because I felt like for a while my perfume collection was just getting out of hand, and I just hadn't really taken the time to sit down and go through every single one of my perfumes and just kind of like decide, okay, like which perfumes do I really, really love. There was just so many perfumes in my collection, like the ones that you're gonna be seeing here, where I liked them, but I just felt like either I wasn't really getting use out of them, or maybe I liked them a little bit, but there was things that I didn't like about them. And I'm like, why am I keeping these types of perfumes in my collection? Just taking up space, collecting dust, not being used, just basically being wasted. I just kind of wanted to start the new year just a little bit less cluttered. And even with 27 perfumes out of my collection, I'm looking at my perfume collection right now and it still looks like no perfumes were gone. Like, it's still just as full. And my goal for this year is to just cut back a little bit, cut back on buying, cut back on collecting perfumes, and kind of making sure that I really, really try to use all of my perfumes. Sometimes I get in this weird idea where I'm like, oh, I don't want to use this perfume because what if I run out of it? But then it's like, okay, if you run out of it, just repurchase it again. Let me know if I'm crazy and I'm like the only one that does that, but like sometimes I have certain perfumes where I'm like, I just need to be super sparing with this because I want to savor every little last drop of it. And I'm like, why are you doing that? If you run out of it, you'll just repurchase it. It's not that big of a deal. I have like this attachment to some of my perfumes that I can't let go of them. But today I was like, no, we're not doing that anymore. I'm gonna get rid of a bunch of these perfumes and I'm not gonna let these go to waste. Obviously, I'm not gonna just trash them. All of these perfumes are gonna be going up on my Mercari. I may give a few of these over to my mom if she likes any of them, because I will tell you right now, the majority of these, I don't think she would even smell because they're just way too sweet for her taste. She likes like more fresher perfumes. And I do have a few of those in here, so if she likes those, she can take them. But I will tell you, the majority of these, if not all of them, will be up on my Mercari. So I will have that linked in my description box if you're interested in purchasing any of these perfumes. It'll be on there. Quick disclaimer as far as my Mercari, because I feel like every time I talk about my Mercari, or just in the past when I've done these types of declutter videos and I let you guys know that these will be up on my Mercari, I get people commenting and telling me like, why are your prices so high? And I'm just tired of having to respond. Basically, if you see a perfume on there that originally you could probably buy for, I don't know, $15, and you see that it's listed for $20-$25, that's just me basically making up for what I'm gonna be spending just to ship that perfume out. Obviously, that includes gas, that includes packaging. I just feel like it's such a waste of time to even comment those comments. Like, if you see a price and that doesn't sit right with you, then just don't buy it. Now, that's not me saying that these perfumes are gonna be listed at like $200. It really just depends on the perfume. It depends on the brand. I put all of that into consideration. I don't even think my prices are that outrageous, like not at all. I don't even make that much money off of these perfumes that I sell. I'm just trying to basically break even and just kind of recycle that money back into buying perfumes. So it's just going right back to my business, you know what I mean? Anyways, I don't want to talk about that a whole bunch because I feel like it's something that doesn't even need to be explained, but I just wanted to address those comments because it always just annoys me every single time I see them. Anyways, with all that said, before we get into this video, please make sure that you're subscribed to my channel and turn your post notifications on, and let's get started. Okay, so keep in mind that a lot of these perfumes I may have talked very highly about in the past. Doesn't mean that I don't like any of these. I feel like most, if not all of these perfumes, I liked at one point, with a couple that are exceptions to that, but there's nothing wrong with any one of these perfumes. It's just for one reason or another, I'm just not really finding that I'm using them a lot, or I just have other perfumes that I prefer to use over these. Let's get started with perfume number one in no particular order. Let me start with this. This is Lancôme Hypnose. Now, as you guys can see by how much juice there is in here, I might have used this maybe once or twice. Like, that's it. When I bought this, I really wanted it just because it's a very unique perfume and very underrated, very not talked about. And those types of perfumes tend to be ones that I gravitate towards because I just like perfumes that you know, not a lot of people know about. And so that's what drew me to this. And that still holds true for this perfume. Like, if you're just looking for a one-of-a-kind perfume you've never smelled before, that is this perfume. I honestly don't even know how to explain this perfume. It's a really, really strange perfume. I feel like it looks like it would be like more like a fresher perfume, but it's actually not. It's a lot stronger than you would think. It's a lot sweeter than you would think. And it's just like a really, really unique blend of notes. I believe there's passion flower in here with some vanilla. It has some like gardenia and some florals. It's a little bit on the mature side. It's not too mature, but it's definitely not gonna be your like juvenile scent. Every time I smell this, I'm like, that is one of a kind. And I still, even smelling it now, I'm like, I don't hate this, but I just have a lot of perfumes that I use over this. And judging by how much I haven't used this perfume, I feel like it's about time that I probably let it go, because if I haven't used it much until now, I probably won't. So that'll be up on my Mercari. Moving on, this is a celebrity perfume. Now, this is called Diamante by Daddy Yankee. Comes with like this little like bracelet, but it has rusted, so I'm just gonna throw that away. I'm not gonna sell it like that. But this is what this perfume looks like. It's in like this deep wine burgundy sort of colored bottle, and there's nothing wrong with this perfume. Yeah, it smells really nice. It's just a little bit generic. It smells like how a lot of celebrity perfumes smell like. It is really nice in the sense that it has like this sweet berry scent. Oh, it smells really good now that I'm smelling at it. But I just have so many perfumes, and I have a lot of perfumes with this scent profile, like sweet berry type of thing. That's basically like 50% of my perfume collection, because those are just like my favorite types of perfumes. So for that reason, I'm just giving this away, just because I have many others in my collection that could substitute this. Pretty much, it is pretty much completely full. I don't think you can tell from the camera, but I've literally maybe sprayed this twice. Here is a mixed bar scent. This is Whipped Almond. Again, a scent that there's just absolutely nothing wrong with this, but I have perfumes that I just go to a lot more. I just never really gravitate towards this. It's like a sweet almondy scent. I don't really know how to explain it. Like, sweet almondy, it kind of almost reminds me of like really, really good hair products. Like, not shampoo, but maybe like a really nice like leave-in conditioner or like luxurious hair product. It has almost like this tonka bean scent to it. It's very creamy, like it's whipped almond. So it has like this creamy almondy scent with like this sweet tonka, almost like vanilla-y scent to it. So it's really sweet for the most part. And it is really nice, but just haven't used it. As you can tell, it's completely full. Also, as I mentioned in my last video, I'm not really sick, but I have this like lingering cough that just will not leave my side. So if my voice is really weird and I'm like literally wheezing, it's because I'm probably coughing like a million times throughout this video. The next perfume that I'm going to be listing is Burberry Body. So as you can see, another one that I've barely used. That was a big deciding factor on a lot of these perfumes, if I was gonna give them away or not, is just based off of how much I use them. I'm like, if I have barely used them, clearly there's something I don't like about them. So if I haven't used them at all up until this point, I'm probably not gonna use them. So this is Burberry Body Eau de Parfum. There's a few different variations of this. I think there's an Eau de Toilette, and then there's a few flankers. Now, the reason why I'm getting rid of this specific perfume is because just recently I discovered a perfume that is so amazing. So when I went to Greece this summer, my cousin was using a perfume, and it was Burberry Body, but it was not the original. It was Burberry Body, what is it called? I have it somewhere over there because I did buy it recently. I think it's like Tender is what it's called. And it is so good. I will be talking about it more in depth in a future perfume haul. But because of that, and because I found that perfume and I prefer it a million times more than this, that is why I'm parting ways with this, because that perfume is just has this sort of DNA, but it's a little bit less mature. It's a little bit like fruitier. There's just something that I prefer in that one more than this. So that's why I'm parting ways with this. This one is just a little bit too floral for me. It lacks like fruits, right? Like, it's a little bit too, I guess, serious. Like, it's a very classy scent, very sophisticated, mature, and very like floral heavy. So if you're into that, you'll probably love Burberry Body, because it is a really, really nice one. It kind of basically embodies the whole brand of Burberry, but I much prefer the flanker to this one. All right, next up, this is a Zara perfume. So I'm quickly sort of like decluttering my Zara perfumes. I think at this point I have about like 4 or 5 Zara perfumes in my collection. I used to have like almost 10 or 11. I've slowly kind of decluttered them because I just, you know, either wasn't using them. A lot of Zara perfumes are dupes for a lot of designer perfumes. So I either got the designer perfume, so there was no need for me to have the dupe. Things like that. So I've slowly kind of cut down, but I think my collection after this one is gone, I think those perfumes will be staying in my collection because I really, really love every single one of them. This is Crispy Gardenia. And the reason why I'm decluttering this is purely because I have the original version of this, which is Black Opium. So this is a dupe to Black Opium. It smells almost like identical to it. I have it on right here. I have like all these perfumes all over my body right now. As I was trying to declutter them, I was like spraying them just to kind of like make sure that I wanted to get rid of them, and I literally put them all over my body. I'm smelling like a million different perfumes right now. This perfume is really, really nice. Like I said, if you like Black Opium or that type of vibe, you would love this. I almost feel like it's a little bit fruitier than Black Opium. Like I almost like this one more. But I just like, I mean, I have Black Opium. There's no reason for me to just let this collect dust. Again, barely used. Next up, this is a Skylar perfume. This is called Honeysuckle Dream. This one I'm just purely getting rid of because it's called Honeysuckle Dream. It's a very, very floral scent, honeysuckle heavy, and honeysuckle has never really been a note that I absolutely love. Although I will say about this perfume, even considering the fact that it's called Honeysuckle Dream and there's a significant amount of a honeysuckle smell in this, I actually don't hate it. Like I actually think it smells like really nice. It smells like spring. Like you're just walking through flowers basically is what this smells like. It's a really, really nice scent, like a breath of spring air. I don't know if this makes sense, but this is a beautiful scent that I love to smell, but I don't want to smell like. I would love this in my environment. If I were to like spray it around me or maybe even as a candle, I feel like that would be nice. I just don't really like smelling this floral because it is a very, 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 very floral scent. But if you're into honeysuckle, this is a beautiful scent. Next perfume is this one. So this is from the Yes I Am line. This is Yes I Am Glorious. This is a flanker to the original Yes I Am. Now, I'm a huge, huge, huge fan of the Yes I Am line. I really love the original, the one in like the red lipstick. I love the purple one. And I had high hopes for this one, and that's not me saying that this is a horrible fragrance, because it's not. It definitely has a little bit of the DNA of those perfumes. But this one is just the most floral out of all of them. It gives me really nice like designer vibes. It smells like peach gummy candy. There's a lot of like sweet notes in it. You get like milk, so it's a little bit creamy. It's a little bit powdery. But I think once this dries down, I get a little bit more floral than I would like to. And I think for that reason is why I'm getting rid of it. So this is just one of those things where I'm trying to be really, really strict and really, really cut down. If I wasn't, this would totally stay in my collection because it's a scent that I really, really like. I'm literally smelling it right now and I'm like telling myself like, do I want to give this away? But I think I am, just because I do prefer the original ones over this. So one of you guys will probably enjoy it. Again, you can't really see it, but it is completely full. That's kind of with all of these perfumes. They're like literally full to the brim. Literally have been sprayed like 2 or 3 times in total. Next up, this is Juicy Couture Hollywood Royal. So I hauled this in a video like a little while back. So this is a Juicy Couture scent. I found this at like a Ross or a Burlington, one of those discount stores. And again, with this scent, there's absolutely nothing wrong with this. It smells a lot like the original Juicy Couture, like not the Viva La Juicy, but just like the original Juicy Couture. It reminds me a lot of it. And I'm just getting rid of this because I have a lot of other Juicy Couture perfumes in my collection that I think smell really, really similar to this perfume. So this is just kind of like a duplicate that I feel like just doesn't need to be in my collection because I have others that smell very similar. So for that reason, I'm getting rid of it. If you like sort of like the Juicy Couture DNA and you're just really into the Juicy Couture perfumes, I think you'll really like this. I believe there's also marshmallow in here, so it's like a little bit creamier than that type of scent. So if you're into that, this is a really, really nice and really, really pretty scent. So that is Hollywood Royal by Juicy Couture. I am getting rid of Fancy Love by Jessica Simpson. So you guys know that it took me a really long time to even come to terms with liking the original Fancy, which I know everyone and their mothers is like head over heels with. It took me a while to like that scent. I really heavily disliked it in the beginning because I felt like that gardenia was just really, really strong in it, and I felt like everybody else was getting something really, really sweet and gourmand out of the scent, and I was getting something very floral, so I felt like my nose was broken. But then I kind of came around, and it is in my collection, and I do really, really enjoy it. And so I bought this Fancy Love thinking that I would like it, and let me say, I don't think this is a horrible scent, but it is way too musky. If you are into musky scents, like a lot of muskier scents, then I think you would really, really like this. Personally, I feel like this smells like bathroom freshener. It's just way, way too musky. Like, way too musky. Like, just that really, really heavy white musk type of scent. If you like that, you would like this, but yeah, no, it doesn't smell bad. I feel like there even is this like expensive scent to it, kind of. Like, I'm totally contradicting myself with what I'm saying right now, but I'm just saying, like, this does not smell bad at all. And I think if you're a musky scent lover, then this would be a beautiful scent for you. But it's just, it's had its time in my collection. I've realized that I haven't used it, and every time I smell it, I'm like, oh, this is too musky. So there's just no reason for this to be in my collection anymore. So that is Fancy Love by Jessica Simpson. Next up, this is Sexy Blossom by Michael Kors. I think this one might be going to my mom. I feel like this is a scent that she would really, really love, because Sexy Blossom is like a very, very floral and fruity type of scent. It's not too, too floral, and it's also not too fruity. It's like a perfect combination of both, to where it doesn't smell like that super heady floral, like very mature florals, but it also doesn't smell like too fruity, like it doesn't smell like a body spray type of thing. It's like a perfect merge of both, and it also has this level of like classy sophistication, matureness to it. It's also a little bit sexy because it's just a really feminine scent. It's a really nice scent. It's just a bit too floral for me, so that's why I'm getting rid of it. So you guys are gonna have to see if this makes it over to my Mercari or if it makes it over to my mom's house. Next perfume, this is Giorgio Armani Si Passione. This perfume is amazing. Like, it actually smells really, really good. Only reason why I'm getting rid of it is just because I feel like it's a bit of a generic scent, and I have a lot of perfumes in my collection that could very easily imitate this or be a substitute for this. So that's the only reason why I'm getting rid of it. I'm leaning over to giving this to my mom because I have used a decent size of it. It's definitely more than half full. Like, it's about, I think, here of product. So it's not like that used, but it's not as new as like a lot of these other perfumes where they're like literally sprayed like two times. This one has a little bit more of a dent, so I do feel like she wouldn't mind the scent. It is a little bit sweet, but it's not too, too sweet. Like, it's also sweet and fruity, and it's not like headache inducing or anything. It's a very easy to wear scent. It also has like some freshness to it. It's a really sexy scent. Like, I really, really like this, but it's just a bit generic. Like, I have other perfumes that could easily be better substitutes for this in my collection, so that's why I'm getting rid of that. Next up, here is another celebrity perfume. This is Kim Kardashian Gold. I don't know what this is called. I think it's just like gold. I'm not sure. This, I'm pretty sure, has been out for a while. This is before she even had KKW. And this is a nice scent, don't get me wrong. Like, I actually think this smells pretty expensive. It smells really nice. It's like a really woody, like almost like cedar-like scent. It has some type of like spice to it. It's like a really spicy vanilla type of scent. It's nice. It also has like this muskiness to it. So I think that's kind of what throws me off with this. But smelling it now, I'm like, this smells really, really good. But again, it's just a scent that I was not using in my collection. I feel like a broken record because I keep repeating that. But as I said in the beginning of this, there's nothing wrong with any of these perfumes. I just don't use them. I have other ones that I prefer using over these. I feel like this would be a really nice sort of like date night going out scent. It's really, really sexy, but I have my go-tos for those types of perfumes, and I'd rather just go to those than go to this. You know what I mean? So this just ends up like collecting dust, and I don't want to do that anymore. So one of you guys could have that. So I'm getting rid of Stella McCartney Pop Bluebell. This is a flanker to the original Stella McCartney Pop, which you guys know is like probably in my like top five favorite perfumes of life. That is one of my just my all-time favorite perfumes ever. It's a really soft, kind of like sweet, powdery, scent. It smells like Barbie dolls. Like, it's just a really, really nice scent. I love, love, love that scent. And Pop Bluebell is very similar to it. It's just a little bit more fresh because of that Bluebell note. I don't have any other perfume in my collection that has a Bluebell note in it. And this basically smells like 80% of what Pop smells like, but it's not as sweet as Pop. And that's what I love about the original Pop. So because of that little tang that this has, it's a little bit more green and it's a little bit more fresh. That's why I'm getting rid of it. I just much, 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 much more prefer the original. And I see myself using that a million times over ever picking up this scent. So that'll be up on my Mercari. I don't know why I keep saying that, because all of these will be up on my Mercari. This next scent, it hurts my heart to part ways with this, because I remember before I got this, this was a blind buy and I wanted this perfume so, so bad. And when I finally got my hands on it, I was so excited and I smelled it. And initially, I didn't hate it, or at least I think I was convincing myself to like it. But ultimately, I just came to the realization that I'm just not a huge fan of this. And that's specifically because of like one of the main notes of this perfume. So this is Paco Rabanne Pure Excess. Now, can we just talk about this bottle? It's a beautiful bottle. There's literally like a snake wrapping around it. It's gorgeous. Like, I love the bottle. It screams sexiness. It's really, really nice. The scent itself is a very unique like take on a sweet fragrance. It reminds me a lot of kind of the scent profile of Black Opium. So if you're into that kind of scent profile, then I think you would like this. But what throws me off about this is the popcorn note. So this has a very, very, very distinct popcorn note, and it really comes out when you first initially spray this. I will say that popcorn note does die down, and the dry down of it is actually pretty nice. Like, it dries down more of like basically almost kind of like Black Opium, but there's just a little hint of popcorniness in there that just kind of lingers, and I just don't vibe with the popcorn note. Like, it's nice, but there's just something that I don't love. Like, everything else I'm like, okay, like I like, but then that popcorn comes in and it just kind of messes things up for me. And like I said, that popcorn note is not there the entire time. Once this has dried down fully on your skin after about like 30 minutes to an hour, it's actually quite nice. But I mean, I have the original Black Opium in my collection, so like, why do I need another one? As much as I want to hold on to this, clearly it has barely been used. It is full to the brim, so there's no reason for me to continue to hold on to this as much as I would want to. So one of you guys could get your hands on it. All right, next up, I'm finally parting ways with my J.Lo Glow. This is the original Glow. Now, I was holding on to this scent purely just because I was gonna make a like J.Lo perfume collection sort of thing of just like all my Jennifer Lopez perfumes. But then I was like, no, like I'm literally holding on to the perfume just to like make a like collection video on it. I'm like, no, I literally do not like this perfume at all. It's literally a bar of soap. If you like the original Dove bar of soap, which don't get me wrong, I love, but like, I have the soap. I don't need a perfume version of it. I don't want to smell like a bar of soap. I mean, if that's your thing, if you're into like really, 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 really clean, soapy scents, this is your girl. But personally, I'm just not. Like, this is literally a bar of soap in a bottle for me. I prefer Miami Glow, which you guys know I absolutely love. And then I recently discovered Enduring Glow, which you guys might have seen in my most recent celebrity perfume haul. That was also really good, because those are just scents that have a little bit more to them. They're sexy, and I love those scents. This is just a little bit too soapy clean for me, like just too much of a bar of soap type of a scent. Next up, I'm parting ways with another Kim Kardashian scent. This is True Reflection, and I don't know why I held onto this for as long as I have. It may look like there's a dent in it. There's no dent in it. It's just that's how much perfume it came with. This is like a really, really musky, heavy patchouli scent. I'm not gonna lie, it's not a horrible scent. It reminds me a lot of the original Jimmy Choo by Jimmy Choo, which I don't own, but I have smelled, and I don't hate it, but the patchouli is definitely a little strong in it. It's kind of like the main part of the fragrance. It is very smooth though, so I will give it that. Like, it's not that annoying, muddy, gross, dirty patchouli scent. It's not horrible, but it's just a little bit too prominent for me to like absolutely love this, and just a little bit too musky. So if you're into like a combination of musky patchouliness, to your scents. This is a nice one. I'm just kind of over it. I have scents that I would much rather use before I would ever use this. Next up, I am parting ways with Banana Republic Tobacco and Tonka Bean. So this one, I just didn't find that I was using this. Tobacco and Tonka Bean is exactly kind of what it sounds like. It's heavy on the Tonka Bean though, a lot more than the tobacco. Kind of don't even really get the tobacco too much in it. There's like this bit of like spice in it, which I think is what is supposed to emulate the tobacco scent, but no, it doesn't have like a smoky type of scent or anything like that. Maybe like leathery, I would kind of describe it, but the Tonka Bean is a lot heavier in it, basically. It's like pretty much all you get, to be honest. It kind of smells like argan oil, like what the scent of argan oil is what this perfume smells like. So totally not a bad scent. I just found that I just was not using this, like the majority of these perfumes. And these Banana Republic scents are unisex. I don't think this one really leans either too masculine or too feminine. It is very sweet though, and it is a bit of like a thicker scent. So I do feel like this is more appropriate for like fall and winter, that type of weather. But yeah, that is Tobacco and Tonka Bean. This one, I'm like still a little unsure about this one. So it may or may not hit my Mercari. I'm leaning more over to getting rid of it though. Let me turn on the light because I feel like it's getting a little dark in here. I feel like that made no difference to you guys, but it made a big difference to me. This is Floral Street by Wonderland. Wait, no. This is Wonderland Peony by Floral Street. I was really excited when I first bought this because this is a very similar scent to Candy Yum Yum by MAC. It also has guava and cotton candy, so it's really, really nice and like sweet and candy-like. But I just was noticing that I would much rather go to my Candy Yum Yum over this because, yes, they're similar scents, but Candy Yum Yum is just top tier and it beats this one by a mile. By a lot more than a mile, to be honest. Like, I love Candy Yum Yum. And I thought that this would be nice to be in my collection because I loved Candy Yum Yum so much. So maybe I would, like, kind of save my Candy Yum Yum and not use it as much if I was using kind of, like, an alternative to it that smelled similar. But then I realized, I'm like, why am I doing that? Why don't I just use the Candy Yum Yum and then when I run out of it, I could just repurchase it? Now, I do feel like Candy Yum Yum is discontinued, so that was another reason why I wanted to find a dupe. And I mean, this comes close to it, but it's just, I still, like, if I have the original, I'd much more use that, if that makes any sense. Like, it's a nice scent, and I'm sure somebody will absolutely love this because it's a beautiful scent, but clearly I have not. Like, it is completely full. Next up, I'm parting ways with Guess by Marciano. So this scent I did use a little bit. It's not like it has a significant dent into it, but it's kind of hard to make dents into perfumes. Like, I feel like people don't realize that, but you have to really, really spray out like a lot of a perfume to make even a little bit of a dent in it. So this one, even though I have used it like a few times, I used it a lot like in layering combinations. And the reason why I'm getting rid of it is just because, I don't know, it's not like the first perfume that I go to. And recently, every time I go to smell it, I find that it's a little bit too powdery for my liking. I think this has like curacao or like some type of boozy note. So it has like this alcoholic beverage sort of scent to it, but it also has like this vanilla vibe, and it's not a bad scent at all. It smells really, really nice, but it just has a little bit of like a powderiness to it that lately it has been kind of sensitive to my nose. So yeah, that's literally it. Like, it smells really, really good otherwise. Maybe by the end of this video I'll be like, ah, no, just kidding, that won't be up on my Mercari, but it most likely will be. Okay, next, this is Intimate Silhouette by, who is this by? Siriano? Oh, Christian Siriano. Yep. Okay, so this was recommended to me after I had bought the original Silhouette perfume. I think this is a flanker of it. And this is nice, but it's a little bit too strong for me, which is crazy for me to say because I love strong scents, but this one is like beyond strong. Like, if you're looking for a perfume that will literally fill up a room, this is it. Like, it's really, really strong and very musky. It's not a bad musk, it's like a really, really sexy musk, but it's really sweet. It kind of has like a Baccarat Rouge vibe to it going on. It's like sweet, musky, sexy, that type of thing. That is the reason why I'm parting ways with this. It's just really, really strong, and that's pretty much it. Doesn't smell bad. It smells really good, actually. I just prefer the original silhouette a little bit more to this, and I find myself just using that one over this, so I just didn't want this to collect dust in my collection anymore. Next up, I'm finally getting rid of a Britney Spears fantasy. So I made my fantasy collection video, which if you guys haven't seen that, check it out. I'll link it up here. But I went through all of my fantasies, which I have like a significant amount at this point, and I'm sure if I really went through my collection, I could probably get rid of a couple more. But just right off the bat, I wanted to get rid of this one because I feel like this one is just the most similar to the original fantasy. So I have the original fantasy. I don't even really use the original fantasy that much. It's more of like a nostalgic sort of perfume in my collection. Like, it's not like a perfume that I necessarily reach for on a day-to-day basis, and I feel like this smells very similar to it. The only difference is that it's just like a little bit more creamy, and that's really about it. Oh, I didn't even say the name of this. This is, I believe it's called Intimate Fantasy. I think she released this with like some lingerie, so it was meant to be like a little bit of like a sexier version of the original. And that's kind of what it is. Like, it's like a creamier, a little bit like sweeter, more vanilla-y version of the original fantasy, which is a little bit more on the sour side. So that's really it. But yeah, that's the only reason why I'm getting rid of that one. Okay, this perfume, I think this will have to be trash because I didn't really get to this fast enough. Now, this is Pacifica Island Vanilla. So one thing about these Pacifica perfumes, they're really good and I love the scent of them. And I've already rebought this because I completely forgot about this and I feel so bad because I basically just wasted this bottle and I didn't get to it before it got bad. It hasn't gone bad completely. I like the juice has completely turned a different color, which that doesn't always mean that a perfume has gone bad just because vanilla scents tend to kind of turn over time, even though the perfume itself hasn't gone bad. But I recently went and smelled a brand new bottle of Island Vanilla and I fell in love and I'm like, yeah, mine is definitely a little off. So I already rebought this perfume. It's back in my collection. So I'm just gonna get rid of this because I feel really bad. I just didn't get to it in time. But Island Vanilla is a really beautiful vanilla scent. It's kind of like a tropical vanilla without it having any type of like coconut or something like that. It just smells like a beautiful vanilla island goddess. This most likely will just be tossed, which I feel really bad for, and I never do that. But with these perfumes, because they're perfumes that are made with like less preservatives and things like that, they just go bad like really, 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 really fast. The next two perfumes I'm getting rid of, I feel bad to do this because I literally just hauled these in my celebrity perfume video that I just did like just a few videos ago. These are the Katy Perry Indie perfumes. This is the original Indie and then Indie Visible. I'm getting rid of this just because when I smelled them in that video, I like them, and still smelling them now, I'm like, these are not bad scents, but I feel like I have so many perfumes in my collection that I prefer way more. And these were blind buys, so I bought them with the intention of like really, really loving them, but they just fell a little bit short. Normally when I blind buy scents and I'm really excited about a scent, I'll go and wear it right away, and I just didn't find myself doing that with these two. So I may end up regretting that, but as for now, these will both be listed on my Mercari. And I know I didn't really describe what they smelled like. If you want to know, go check them out in my most recent celebrity perfume haul. And then the last three scents that I have to show you guys, I actually haven't shown any of these ever in my videos because these are perfumes that I had bought with the intention of filming a haul on, and I still hadn't gotten around to it. But for one reason or another, I decided to just get rid of them because I just don't really love them. So let's start off with this one. So this is CK1 Shock. This is the Calvin Klein Shock perfume. Now, I bought this and I bought a freaking huge bottle of it. I don't know why, but Calvin Klein perfumes come in like gigantic sizes. This is a 6.7 fluid ounce perfume. This will literally last you three lifetimes. It's absolutely massive, like bigger than my head. I bought this thinking that I would really like it because when I saw the notes, it has really, really nice notes. Notes that are right up my alley. Very sweet, a lot of vanilla. So I'm like, ooh, like that definitely sounds like a me perfume. There's even chocolate in this perfume. There's blackberry, there's passion flower, there's poppy, peony, vanilla. A lot of really, really nice notes. Definitely on the sweeter side, but it falls short. And purely because of that, I'm getting rid of it. Totally not a bad scent. Absolutely nothing wrong with it. I just have so many perfumes with a similar scent profile. It was a blind buy, so I was hoping I would get a little bit more out of this perfume than what I got. But ultimately, it fell short for me. So that is why it is going up on my Mercari. But somebody will be really, really happy with this perfume because it literally will last you. You will literally not need another perfume. Like, you could wear this 6 times a day, you could spray it and you'll still have product for like 100 years. Then this perfume, this is actually by Dossier. Now I found this at a Walmart randomly because Walmart actually has Dossier now. So I bought Gourmand White Flowers by Dossier. Now Dossier is a dupe perfume house. They dupe a lot of like designer niche perfumes, and Gourmand White Flowers is actually a dupe for Flower Bomb by Victor and Ralph. And only reason why I'm getting rid of this is just because I recently bought the original Flower Bomb. I used to have it a long time in my collection and then I gave it away. And recently I really, really wanted it back, and I have it back now, and I've been using it and I really, really like it. And before I had it, this was working fine for me. I didn't even wear it that much to begin with, but now that I have the original, I'm like, I don't need both. I will say though, if you're looking for a good dupe to Flower Bomb, this is it, because it literally smells identical to Flower Bomb. Identical. Literally smell absolutely no difference between the two. So if you want a cheaper version of Flower Bomb, go with Gourmand White Flowers by Dossier. And then the very last scent that I'm getting rid of, this is Alfred Sung She. I don't know what possessed me to get this perfume, because this is totally out of my perfume like taste. Like, it is just not something that I would gravitate towards ever. But I don't know, I think I saw it at like a TJ Maxx and I'm like, I see this all the time here, maybe it's good. Decided to give it a try, and no, it's not bad, but it's just way too much of a fresh, like, just got out of the shower scent. It's like a really, really aquatic scent, very, very clean smelling, not a bad scent by any means, but just too much of a like just got out of a shower scent for me. And you guys know I'm more into like the heavy sweet scents, so yeah, just for that reason I'm getting rid of it. But I don't think it's bad. Like, I'm smelling it now, I'm like, this smells really nice. I feel like this is a scent that my mom would really love, because she loves these like cleaner aquatic floral type of scents. That's exactly what that is. So I'm probably gonna give this one to her to smell before I list it. That is it for this video. I feel like I've been filming for so long, and like I said, I'm still sick, so I've coughed about 3 million times throughout this entire video and my throat is literally burning, so I can't wait to stop talking. Let me know if you're thinking of purchasing any of these. Let me know which perfumes that you're parting ways with. If you're doing like a little bit of a clean out of your collections, let me know in the comments. But that is it for me today. Check out my Mercari if you're interested in any of these perfumes. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and turn your post notifications on, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Thank you.